okay, I am not the biggest hip hop now. Why can't I speak hip hop guy ever? The only people that I listen to in hip hop is Dr. Dre, Eminem, Snoop, like all the old guys, all the Bone Thugs and Harmony. I listen to them once in a while, Outkast once in a while, MF Doom. But like, I don't really like hip hop. Isn't really like my genre. That's not really what I go for. I'm kind of more into like metal, pop punk, punk, punk rock, heavy metal. That's kind of what I go for. But anyways, you guys already know what to do. Like the video. I know the intro was long, but you guys already know what to do. Like the video and subscribe if you want to see me react to more Kendrick. Subscribe if you want to see me react to more J. Cole. And I know he came out with the off album, or what was it called, off album. I forgot what it was, but it's like the basketball hoop on fire. Like, I'll react to that if this gets like, maybe if we can hit 10 likes, I'm gonna react to the off season album. Okay, I'm like, whoa, it's, I'm having a brain fart, but whatever. I'm gonna listen to it in crudging. I can't speak English today. I'm gonna start from the beginning to the end. Okay, you guys already know what to do, and we're getting straight into it. Okay, let's see what you got, J. Cole. I heard this song everywhere. I'm telling you, like, you couldn't escape this song. It was like Hotline, like, you couldn't escape it. I don't know when this came out, though. I do like the beat, though. The beat is actually good. First things first, recipe, sucker fair. For real, you the only father that I ever knew. I get my bitch pregnant, I'ma be a better you. Prophecies that I made. Okay, wait, hold on. Was that a reference to the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Uncle Phil? I'm pretty sure. I forgot. I haven't seen the Fresh Prince in Bel-Air in years. Like, I saw that when I was little, but for fear. Listen, even back when we was broke, my team ill. Martin Luther King would have been on Dreamville. Talk to her, nigga. One time for my LA sisters. One time for my LA hoes. Lame niggas can't tell the difference. One time for a nigga who knows. Don't save her. She don't wanna be saved. Don't save her. She don't wanna be. Ooh, I like this. Wait, hold up. Okay, never mind. We're gonna go back to that later. No models and I'm here right now. No role models to speak of. Searching through my memory, I couldn't find one. Last night I was getting my feet rubbed by the baddest bitch. Not Trina, but I swear to God. Okay, hold up, J. Cole. Okay, now we know he's into feet. Make you call your girl up and tell her, hey, we don't kink shame here. We don't kink shame. They hang the phone up and proceed to lay the wood. I came fast like 911 in white neighborhoods. Ain't got no shame about it. She think I'm spoiled and I'm rich because I can have any bitch. I got defensive and said, nah, I was the same without it. But then I thought back to a better me. Before I was B-list celebrity. I do like the hook. The hook is actually catchy. Lame niggas can't tell the difference. One time for a nigga who knows. Don't save her. She don't wanna be saved. 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 Dark skin and Aunt Viv love for my LA sisters. One time I really like the I really like the hook. Can't tell the difference. One time for a nigga who knows. Don't save her. She don't wanna be saved. Just save her. She don't wanna be saved. She don't wanna be saved. She don't wanna
be saved. There's an old saying in Tennessee. I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me once. Shame on.
Okay, I did not expect this little like radio. Like, I don't know if you. Okay, I'm gonna make a connection here. For the ones that listen to Logic, I'm just making the connection here because Logic listens to. He brings in Alan Watts quotes once in a while. I know in The Incredible True Story, he has. I think it was in the song after Intermission. I forgot what it's called. I think it was The Incredible True Story. I think that was the very last song on that album. But he made that. He brought in the Alan Watts quote. And then he did the same thing for No Pressure. When he put Alan Watts on Sincerely Yours, I think. And I'm just making the connection because J. Cole brought in this quote. I don't know exactly where it's from. I have heard this quote before, but I never heard. I thought it was just like, I didn't think it was from an interview or whatever it is, like a news conference room. I don't know what it was from. But everybody's heard that quote at least once in their life, right? So I'm just making that connection here. So let's just continue. Oh, okay. He's going off of it. Okay. Fool me three times, fuck the peace sign, load the chopper, let it rain on you. Fool me one Scarface, time, okay, I just thought of Scarface from there. Put the blame on you. Fool me three times. sign, fuck the peace sign, load the chopper, let it rain on you. My regret was too young for Lisa Bonet. My only regret was too young for me alone. Now all I'm left with is hoes from reality shows. Hand her a script, the bitch probably couldn't read alone. My only regret was too young for Sade Adu. My only regret could never take her okay. home. I don't know who any of these people are, so if you know who they are, just let me know down in the comments. I'm thinking they're probably people in, like, famous or something, or like, okay, I don't know why I'm thinking of porn stars, but that's what I'm thinking. Okay, I don't know. I could be wrong. Let me know down in the comments. I don't know. Now all I'm left with is hoes up in Greystone with the stale face because they know it's they song. She's shallow with the pussy. She's shallow. Wait. Okay, hold up. Let's run it back. Okay, he said something that this song is meant for them, and the song is called No Role Model. So is he saying that because they had no role models, they ended up being hoes or something? Like, wait, hold on. Let's just run it back. This is okay. Look. Okay. I could be wrong about all this. She don't wanna be saved. Dude, I love this. I like the hook. I don't know how I didn't like pay attention to this before. Is this a song that made J. Cole? I don't know. I'm pretty sure. I'ma just assume that it did because it's like the most famous one. It has like 1 billion streams on Spotify. So I'm guessing or assuming that this is the song that made J. Cole. Just let me know down in the comments because I do not know anything about J. Cole. I just know that he's been around for a while. She don't wanna be saved, don't save her. She don't wanna be saved, don't save her. She don't wanna be saved. Does it fade out? Okay, that's it. Okay, overall thoughts on the song. I actually like it. I don't know how I didn't listen to this before. Like, I heard just the intro, like the dun 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 dun. But then after that, never paid attention, like, at all. Never even cared for it. But how do I miss this? It's like, I like the hook. The hook was pretty catchy. And I want to know who those people's names were. Like, was he, like, taking shots at somebody that he knows? Or, like what was he doing with those names? Like, I want to know. Was I right about the whole, like, oh, they didn't have, like, a role model or something and then they ended up being hoes or something? Like, let me know down in the comments if I was just let me know down in the comments if I was right about any of this, because I'm pretty sure I'm just throwing thoughts out here and seeing what sticks on the wall, and just let me know what the whole meaning of the song is. I'm pretty sure it's like, I'm 100% sure that they didn't have a role model or anything to guide them in life, and then they ended up becoming all these people, and then he's kind of got tired of it or something. I don't know. Maybe he didn't have a role model, and he ended up going in that route of his life, and then he's like, nah, I don't wanna deal with it. I don't know. Let me know down in the comments. That's the vibe I was getting off the song. I'm pretty sure, 100% sure, it was about the girls that he was taking shots at. I don't know if those were taking shots, but he was just calling them out. And I will be reacting to more J. Cole if we can hit 10 likes on this video. If we can hit 10 likes, I will listen to the off-season album. Or we can go from the very beginning, his off his first album. Is it like that one where he's like sitting on the thing? I'm pretty sure that's his first album, right? I don't know. I don't really catch up with J. Cole. Like, this is my first time actually like paying attention to him. Yeah, let me know if I was right. Let me know down in the comments, and I'll see you guys later. This video was pretty long in my opinion. I think it was the longest video that I ever done for a reaction, but just let me know, and I am out.